In 1936, Roy Kane arrived in Winston-Salem for a job in the textile industry, having just departed Roanoke, Virginia. While there, he was a member of the group that was known as the Roanoke Life-Saving Crew, the first volunteer rescue squad in the United States. The rescue squad concept was the brainchild of Roanoke businessman Julian Stanley Wise. In 1909, Wise was walking along the banks of the Roanoke River in Roanoke, Virginia, when he witnessed two men capsize a canoe in deep, rough water. Though many onlookers saw the accident, none of them had the equipment or the training to offer much help, and both men drowned. Wise later said, "I vowed that I never again would watch a man die when he could have been saved if only those around him knew how." That incident stayed with Julian, and on May 28, 1928, Julian and nine co-workers at the Norfolk and Western Railway began their first volunteer rescue squad. When Kane arrived in Forsyth County, there was no such agency in existence in the county or even the state. Seeking the support of Thurman Chatham, a local businessman and civic leader, they together became the core of the beginning of the new agency, the Winston-Salem Rescue Squad. The agency was established in 1937 and began training and raising funds for equipment. Starting with a small group of 15 to 20 men, the agency responded to emergencies such as traffic accidents and drownings in lakes and rivers. During the 1940s, the squad maintained a stockpile of iron lungs for the treatment of polio and even assisted in moving the devices to different hospitals and polio camps all across northwestern North Carolina. Prior to the creation of home health agencies, the squad maintained a stockpile of durable medical equipment such as oxygen tanks, crutches, wheelchairs, and hospital beds for those needing home care. Along with funeral homes, the squad also provided ambulance transportation to the sick and injured, long before the creation of the Forsyth County Ambulance Service in 1968. The squad found its largest and ultimately final home in 1968 when it opened the state-of-the-art station on North Liberty Street, right beside the newly constructed Winston-Salem Fire Station 3. As the 1970s continued, the squad was instrumental in training Forsyth County volunteer fire departments in the art of rescue services as they worked together to provide high-quality service to the citizens of the county. One of the most important roles for the squad was support of crash fire rescue services at Smith Reynolds Airport. The rescue squad was a common sight at football games, rodeos, and the Dixie Classic Fair, providing medical coverage to the attendees in case of emergencies. Over the years, the rescue squad provided not only basic rescue services, but was the second squad in the state recognized as a heavy rescue provider by the State Rescue Association in the late 1990s. Services were expanded to include collapse and cave-in events, water and dive rescue events, and the agency was the first in the state to have a dedicated animal rescue unit. The squad also won the State Rescue Association Heavy Rescue Competition twice in the 1990s. The story of the agency is only as remarkable as the people who formed the squad. In the mid-1990s, over three-fourths of the membership roster had college degrees. They answered calls at a moment's notice and spent countless hours staffing the station and training to improve their skills, all done without receiving any pay for their time. As the community grew, the number of volunteers declined along with the expansion of services from the city and county, so the rescue squad entered into an agreement to merge with Forsyth County EMS in 2009. This arrangement allowed the members to continue to serve and the equipment assets to be utilized, but in a smaller role. This merger continued until 2013 when the EMS divested itself from rescue services, turning their services over to the Winston-Salem Fire Department and the fire volunteer programs in Forsyth County. And the remaining membership and equipment was transferred to Mineral Springs Volunteer Fire Department. The heavy rescue unit was repainted, but door plaques and decals were added, giving credit to where the apparatus came from and to the members who served the community over 70 years. Eventually, every county in North Carolina had some form of rescue squad. The citizens of the state are indebted to Roy Kane and the Winston-Salem Rescue Squad for the foresight to form such an agency and to become the leader in emergency and rescue care. For such vision and devotion to community well-being, it's appropriate that the Forsyth County Historical Resources Commission honored the state's first and oldest rescue squad with a marker commemorating the Winston-Salem Rescue Squad.